Well, hi people. This is an absolutely spectacular ride in South Ayrshire. It's a loop of about 27 miles beginning at the town of Maybole and following NCR7 for much of the route. So here's whereabouts we're heading from. You can see Glasgow and Carlisle there on the map just disappearing, and Killian Castle is not very far over to the west. So we're starting up at Maybole and we're going to go clockwise around this loop through Cross Hill, down through all this forestry land. The quality of the road is absolutely spectacular. Hit Balloch and then follow the river along through farm, then hit Milton Bridge and we just head straight north again. And there's a bit of a dogleg just beyond Wallacetown to avoid going on the main road, and it means that we can cut round a little back road, rejoin the NCR7 and then back up to Maybole. So here we are in a more terrestrial view. Very quickly follow it around down through the forestry once we've gone through a little bit of town, then at the bottom follow along that river valley, then head north again, and then a quick dogleg around here just to avoid the main road, and then back into Maybole. None of the roads are particularly busy, just one little bit towards the end that we try and minimise. So here we are leaving our campsite. We're actually on the road. Behind us is Maybole, very, very distinct, heading straight south out of the town. Now the road quality for almost the whole route, it's just one bit, is spectacular. You can do it all on road tyres if you wanted, but they are digging it up in places. So there's quite a lot of work going on, huge amount being spent on road improvement. But you can see the standard of this road here. You know, it's not being dug up, it's not like we used to in Surrey. So just up here, we're actually going to turn left at these kennels and then we follow this old road. Now that one is a little bit more beat up, so watch out for it. I think they're just going to do a resurface over the whole thing. Although this one in itself is better than most of the roads that we ride around in Surrey. Quick right turn there, following along this slightly larger road that's been reasonably well made up, and it's downhill now. And then we get to the junction at the end and we're turning right into Cross Hill. This is about the only town that you'll encounter, and it's not very large at all. It was almost completely silent, very few other cars, road surface falling apart at times. So whilst you watch this, it'd be worthwhile just clicking underneath on the subscribe button so that you can keep in touch with us, and don't forget to hit like, and we'd love you to leave some comments underneath. So we're following along out of Cross Hill, and we're really continuing to head south now towards the forestry land, and we're not long before we start seeing the blue signs. We're going to go over this little crossroads here, and then the signs start appearing. There they are on the left to say that we're in forestry land. And this is where the quality of the road surface is quite almost unprecedented in all the rides that we've done. Completely flat, barely the odd stone gets knocked in from the side, but other than that, it's in impeccable condition. Now there's a climb here, and it was a little bit shady, but fortunately it was quite a warm day. There's the odd farm, but really very little traffic. You'll see on this video that actually most of the traffic that we encounter is tractors. So we're working our way up the hill, and there is quite a tall climb to get over the top. So if you look at the topographic chart right in the bottom left there, we're actually heading up this first long climb, and it is quite long and it goes on for a little while, but it's not insurmountable. I think it was about 4%, 5%. But it does go on for a reasonable distance. Again, you can see the road quality is remaining excellent, and it's a little while before the terrain opens out. But now as we head around just the back end of that first bit, which is mostly farming, we now start to get onto this super quality road surface. And we're going to get into a slightly more open area where it's been cleared now, and that sort of stands out as a bit of a rectangle in the map. But absolutely excellent. But you'll see we're still climbing, and there's a substantial way to go. Our lad, we keep going on ahead. Ignore the signs that saying the road is closed. That's almost certainly because there's other work going on, but as cyclists you can get past. Now the countryside has opened up, and you can see these vast open swathes of conifer plantation that have been cleared. We had a very mixed day with the odd specks of rain amongst the beautiful sunshine. very difficult to control the temperature as we were climbing. We're still climbing, and now we're just getting towards a little bit of a descent, but it's really an on-off place, but wonderful views from the top here. So if we just rise to the edge of this first hill, you'll start to see that it'll open up, and we actually found ourselves a little lay-by to stop, have a drink, catch our breath after the climb. So we're pretty much nearing the top now, and we're beginning to sort of head back down. I think it's pretty level here. So just after here was where we stopped. On the right, just to have a little bit of a look at the environment that was around. Yeah, maybe we went past these trees, but really quite warm actually, because of that open ground, the sun beating off it, but plenty to see, plenty to do. So we stopped in over here, and there's plenty of passing spaces, but look at the standard of that road. Nothing wrong with it at all. So off we go, and from here on it's almost a long descent, and you can see in the topographic chart that we've got a very steep descent, and then it levels off a little bit, but it still continues to go down. So we're heading down now, and the occasional little blip in that, but so I think we might have gone up for a little bit, but then there's a long descent back down, and that's where we get to North and South Balloch, and we're going to have to do a little bit of a dogleg around those, but it's still quite a way off, and this has been the easiest bit of riding you've ever done, because it's just straight downhill. So try not to go too fast, because you're not quite sure what's around the next corner, the odd car, but very rare. So getting quite fast here, and getting back into the more rural community, following around, and you can see the farms down there on our right, which is what we're going to go around in a minute. The roads are not really wide enough for multiple cars, and this was the peak of the summer holidays, so not only were the English on holiday in Scotland, but the Scots were there too. So we turn right into this farm here, and now we follow along this road. Now this road is not quite so well maintained, but it's still pretty good condition in comparison with a typical road in Surrey. And we follow along. Now there's not many places to stop, but the views are really nice and it's very peaceful. So we're going to work our way all the way along. The river is snaking its way along on our right at the bottom of the valley. Farmers have just finished harvesting their silage, so the fields are all quite clear and open, and sheep were being put on to sort of finish off the sward. But work our way past ash and rowan, round underneath a bit of beech cover, and a little bit of a descent here as we drop down to the river, which will show itself there. So we stopped at this point and had some lunch, and this is the bridge that we're going to have to cross in a minute, but very peaceful little road. So we're going to ride over that and follow around up towards Wallacetown, really. Couldn't see any trout. I was looking, that's why I went over there, have a look for the trout. But off we go again, and we're just going to follow this road round. And there's just a couple of places where as we get towards the railway, that we want to get to the other side of it. So now we're on that second ascent, that second hill that you can see, and we're really heading towards a whole set of windmills that are over the top of the next hill. Can't see them here, but they'll start to appear in a minute. So we're working our way right up to the top of this next hill. Now actually, although it is not very long necessarily, you can see that it is fairly steep, and this will keep you warm as we get up there. But this road itself has got far fewer traffic on it, and those which are there are mostly, really, people that appear to have got lost, because I'm not quite sure where it goes. But now you can start to see the windmills, or the wind turbines, as they're correctly known, appearing. And we're going to head up towards the top of the hill. It can get pretty blowy up here, but actually after climbing, that helps you to cool down a little bit. And then we're going to have a quite a steep descent over the other end, so a little bit of a bounce there, a little bit more climbing, and once we get past those turbines, then we're going to start heading down. There was actually a reservoir on the left at one point, just beyond some trees, but we didn't get to see it. So we are going around the corner, and now from here on, really, it's almost descent. We're now just at the top of the hill, and we start picking up some speed, as you can see. Tight corner here, and a couple of other tight corners just watch out for. Over the cattle grids again, they were quite slippery, but now we're heading around back down the hill, and it's a very, very sharp descent at one point. So make sure your brakes are up to standard before you leave. And we're going to head towards the B741, and then we're going to turn right at that. So we're going to descend down here with the hedge on our right until we hit the road at the bottom. There it is. Turn right. Now this is the main road back that really heads all the way to Maybole. So just be a little bit careful of the traffic at certain times of day. But as you can see, it's not exactly the busiest road in the country. And we're going to take an optional turn here. So where that tractor came out, this is a turn. We weren't even sure if it was right. Sometimes commute sends you the wrong way. But we followed around through this farm and then followed the track out. Now this is a little bit of gravel that we've got here. So just be warned of that, that it is a little bit bumpy, although it's not too bad. And then we're just going to rejoin a road parallel with the main road. You can see it started to rain, and now we're carrying on back towards Maybole. This was a very quiet bit of road, much nicer than the earlier bit that we did, and soon we'll rejoin our original route, and then we can head back up to Maybole. So you can see now that we've done the second peak and descended right down into the valley, we've got another very gradual incline as we rise up just a couple of hundred feet, really. So through more forestry. There was evidence that some of these trees had fallen down, so it is worth checking that you have a clear route. Have a look, see what happens, see whether Google Maps is showing that the traffic is delayed at any point. But now we're making to the top, and we're now on the level ground towards the top of that final rise. And after a few more turns, we're going to head back down the hill towards Maybole. So here we go, heading back down under the bridge. And our campsite was on the right, but you can see Maybole rising up ahead of us. Look, as we come around the corner, there's Maybole in the distance, and we get here. So thank you for joining us on this ride. If you go to our commute page, which is Paul and Diane on the Tandem, you'll find this ride down, and if you search for Maybole, and if you bring up our page, not only have you got the full map of it, but if you go on the right hand side there, you'll see export to GPS device. That means you can take off the GPX root folder and a root file, and you can load it into your Wahoo or your Garmin and then set it up for a ride, or you can even just put it onto your phone into commute and off you go. So thank you very much for joining us. We look forward to seeing you on our next ride. We've got a couple more in Scotland. We didn't spend nearly as much time riding in Scotland as we wanted to. So all the best, and see you soon. Bye.